IVM. Hello and welcome to Smile India. I'm your host Shifa Maitra, and today I get you some uplifting stories from across the nation. As we approach the weekend, I hope you're managing a routine while working from home. I still make sure my Sundays are to chill. Workers have moved to their hometowns and one wonders how they manage there. Well, here is an update from Bihar on what I call the Biryani Brigade. In the Banka district, officials were aware of a host of men who'd come back from Telangana. The men were called to meet the district magistrate, so they came with the most delicious biryanis, kebabs and vegetarian dishes. The officials were impressed and got to know that these cooks all worked at high-end restaurants in Hyderabad. Next, the police department got goodies. Now the management is getting them tie up with food businesses and have already given them catering orders for official government functions. Well, Hyderabad's loss seems to be Patna's gain. Another amazing news comes in from Madurai, where 13-year-old M. Netra lives. Her father runs a small salon and everyone was home due to the lockdown. She was moved by the plight of the workers who were unable to make ends meet. She knew her father had saved up 5 lakhs for her higher education. She insisted this money be given to the needy. Seeing how distraught she was, her parents did not have a choice. So Netra went and distributed the money to the needy. Someone from their locality mentioned it to the local corporator, and in a couple of days, she heard from the United Nations. She got a scholarship for her higher studies and has been invited to Geneva to speak at the United Nations conference. She's also been declared the Goodwill Ambassador for the poor. Netra has shown us that listening to your inner voice is always a good thing. Young people these days are on a roll. Arshad from Kochi is a class 9 student who during the lockdown did something unbelievable. His father has an automobile workshop and the boy would keep hanging around there. Once he was caught tinkering with some old scrap from bikes and his father lost his cool. That's when Arshad told him of his plan to make a lightweight bike only from scrap. His father encouraged him but wasn't too sure of the outcome. The boy spent a month and a half on his dream and made something stunning. His bike has a petrol tank attached to the seat and handles with the capacity to hold 1 liter of fuel. Arshad claims that the bike can travel up to 50 kilometers on a full tank. Manufactured with scrap tires, disc brakes, LED lights and handles of other bikes and carrier and seat of bicycles, the inventor spent only 10,000 to develop a light motorcycle. Now that's called lockdown learning. Besides the virus, Assam is also dealing with floods. Yet there's good news from there as well. While the administration is doing what it can, there's someone who's helping. Gautam Bardoi is from Dibrugarh. His home is on a street called Hiramba Bardoi Path, named after his father, who was a teacher and journalist. Every year, this road during the floods would be in shambles. He used to see his father and his friends putting bricks so people could walk. After his father passed on, he decided to do something. So 7 years ago, he took up this street and 4 more important ones in town. He figured that this is an annual disaster. So with his personal funds, he got the drainage system fixed, got the roads elevated and ensures their maintenance throughout the year. His business requires him to live in Shanghai and Hong Kong for a large part of the year, so he gets ideas and inputs from there. After spending lakhs on the road and ensuring they look lovely too, Gautam got the district commissioner to inaugurate one of them. Being the change you want to see in society is possible. Now here's something you can do. No, you don't have to repair roads, don't worry, but try and look after your own mental well-being. As Amitabh Bachchan recently tweeted, the virus is affecting all of us, whether you're ill or healthy. So make sure you watch out for signs of anxiety in yourself and those close to you. It's okay if you have days where you don't feel like doing anything. Do not berate yourself. Reach out to friends and family who are living by themselves. It makes sense to talk to a mental health professional online or telephonically if you're feeling out of sorts. While you're at home, smile, sing, dance, dress up for yourself. And believe me, this too shall pass. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on IVM Network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on our social media. We are at IVM Podcast on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, it's at Shifa Maitra on Instagram and Twitter. Have fun. I'll see you in the next episode.
I hope you enjoyed that show. I'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Paytm Money. So a great week of shows behind us, and hope that you've been catching up on as much of it as you can. We had Abhishek Bachchan on Football Shootball. Yeah, let me say that again. Abhishek Bachchan was on Football Shootball. Did I mention Abhishek Bachchan was on Football Shootball? That was a fun episode. You should definitely check that out. Really, really deep conversation about cricket and things like that. We had Vikram Kochar on Cyrus Says, talking about Z platforms and stuff like what's going on over there. On the note, Maruk had spoken to Sanjay Jha, which was, again, a really, really interesting conversation. On Edges and Sledges, the guys are having an interesting conversation about, well, you know, what are favorite formats of cricket and things like that. So it's just really been a really, really awesome week on the network, and please do check things out. And with that, hope to see you next week.
Entertainment is like food for the brain. It's a window to culture and a great way to understand the world around us. The internet has changed what it means to be an entertainer, creating new storytellers with millions of fans. It has spawned a new breed, the story sellers, those behind the scenes creating the business for this ecosystem. They work with brands, platforms, and channels who are keen to capitalize on an audience hungrier than ever for more stories. I'm Vineet Kanabar, and I have a ringside view to how stories are told and sold. On my show, I bring you creators, artists, executives, and marketers for a freewheeling conversation around the business of entertainment. Tune in to Storytellers and Story Sellers for personal stories, analysis, and criticism every Thursdays as I talk to the brightest minds telling or selling great stories today.